Since 1674, the Order of Preachers has celebrated all of its saints on November 7th. Not only the great saints who are declared, but holy friars, nuns, sisters, Third Order members who have lived through the past 800 years. Martyrs, confessors, virgins, holy men and women who all have their place of honor in the order. Sisters who educated thousands of souls and Third Order members who sanctified the world. These are the forgotten saints that are celebrated on this great family day of the Dominican Order. The Litany of the Dominican Saints continues to be a powerful prayer as we ask the intercession of our brothers and sisters in heaven. The lay Dominicans have this on their site, that Innocent IV became a foe of the order when the Dominican community in Genoa, the Pope's hometown, would not give him their priory and its land for a castle he wanted to build there to protect his relatives from his enemies. Angered for their ingratitude, he placed some restrictions on the Dominicans in the French towns, and then eventually signed a decree rescinding all the privileges of the Order of Preachers and forbidding them to preach, to receive lay people in their churches, to hear confessions without permission of the bishop. A cardinal who supported the Pope in this affair even had further restrictions to suggest to Innocent. On the day the Pope signed the document, the cardinal tumbled down some stairs and shortly thereafter died of injuries, and the Pope himself on the same day, November 21, 1254, after signing the decree, suffered a stroke which left him paralyzed. 16 days later, Pope Innocent died, and Pope Alexander IV restored all the privileges to the order on December 22nd. As a result, the saying arose, "Beware the litanies of the Dominicans." The litany is therefore recommended as a novena in especially crucial circumstances. Saint Dominic de Guzman was the founder of the Order of Preachers. However, in Calaruega, his mother, Blessed Jane Diaza, is much more famous. She really was known for her care for the poor, which is evidenced in Dominic's life. It is not surprising that Dominic would become a saint, as his family were all blesseds in the church. Dominicans were an itinerant community, going out to reach people who are in need throughout the world and try and proclaim the gospel to them. Dominic always wanted to go and preach throughout the world, but instead he ended up investing Hyacinth to preach to the people of Poland along with his cousin. Catherine took care of the sick. She was a doctor of the church. She brought the Pope back from Avignon and also worked for peace throughout Italy. We have our scholars and teachers like St. Albert the Great and Thomas Aquinas, and many more to this day. We have saints like St. Antoninus, who cared for the poor in Florence, St. Martin de Porres, St. Rose of Lima, and St. John Maxius, who did so in Latin America. In Rosary Hall, we find a lot of the women who were very influential in the early monasteries throughout Europe. We also see those who showed us the way to pray, those who were mystics, and those who really reached out to the poor. We have artists like Fra Angelico, martyrs like John of Cologne, and thousands of others. We have those who face special challenges, like Blessed Margaret Castello, who was a dwarf, humpback, and blind. She was left homeless on the streets when her parents took her to a shrine for a cure. One of our latest saints, Blessed Maria Alfonsina Daniel Gattas, worked with the poor and with those people in the Middle East, especially in Jerusalem. The saints include all of us who are baptized and called to be the elect, and many others who are called to be united with Christ in life and in death. We have many saints that we know, those who are not canonized, but are definitely part of our Dominican family. In the 150th anniversary celebration of our congregation, we walked through the cemetery praying for each of our sisters who had died. And after that, we prayed for the names, as names were called, of each of the sisters in the congregation. We are united in a communion of saints, now and forever. Amen.